We are back and right into the pistol. Gump going to be able to find that opening going fast at yard and full wrapping over towards Hellside. Let's see if Flycatcher are going to be able to find an answer back. Liaz missed opportunity, but he's got the info that it will be this heaven wrap. Liaz in a very odd position here at lockers. All eyes on him. Coming in from the flank side, Ricky makes it work, flicks around for that next one, and FlyQuest might be losing the pistol here. 1v5 attempt for Dexter.
Yeah, it's a fantastic start. See if Dexter, I mean, really, once you're in this position on the CT side, you start going for exits at some point. Oh. How has B been allowed up the ladder? That should not be allowed to happen. He's got three. Oh, Dexter trying to hold on. Right on Silo's side, Ricky is very far away. It's great that he hit that shot because things were starting to spiral out of control. Ricky had only just made it up into heaven, but that's a good couple of kills at the end of the round. Now Dexter could do exactly that. Three kills means that's A1S money, and you're dropping that over to one of the other boys and force buying round two. Things can get a little bit difficult for Mindfreak.
That was crazy. Who was that? Gump? Needs to get off bloody stretched if he's playing positions like that. Silly Billy. Well, let's have a look. Mind Freak, happy with the pistol. Gonna be going for the outer smokes. And we got from Alien here. Alien Inns going for the nice boost over credit. Not gonna be able to see anything, but they should have heard that cross coming through. Looks like they haven't, though.
Yeah, Tux. Crossing straight into secret. Looks like the rest of Mindfreak want to try to meet up with him by forcing their way through ramp. Liaz pushed off the line. Can't quite connect, and Mindfreak going to slow things down now.
Okay. Tux managed to catch Ali, who was going for a sneaky look. And Tux looking for even more. Dexter. Burnt down, sent back through the holes. FlyQuest just trying to figure out where to put their pieces here in the 4v5 to try and get back into the round.
Yeah, Liaz has been dropped off in lower. That's a hell of a shot from him, but he's traded pretty quickly. Vexar's found Tux in the meanwhile, and FlyQuest have got control of Windows and Deacon.
Sneaking through the smoke here. Pain popping out on sight. Dexter can't get enough damage done to finish off Pain, but gives the other two an opportunity. And Inns still yet to fully reveal that M4. He's to trade. Gets the first. Knows that Gump is up on the rafters. And it's a hard crossfire between him and Texter here. Just trying to figure out who's taking contact first. It's Gump. Swinging, fighting. 5-1 and 2-0 for Mindfreak.
Good start, dealt with the force by quite nicely. Now a chance to start to build up their economy. And it's back, Mac. From back in the day, finally, you get the chance to say Texter, Dexter, Texter, Dexter over and over again for 3 hours. Are you looking forward to it?
I'm excited. Texter, Dexter.
It's always Dexter, but never Sexter.
Well, I thought Dexter was going fast out hut. Maybe thinking about a little contact here. Wants to press util. Ali gets some damage done. Dexter with the finisher on that P250. And Tux gets one on the fadeaway. Knows that he's been knocked down to 24 points of health. Dexter with the M4 retrieved is able to get more damage done. Pain chases him down and even swaps out to the AK to save the round. Quick on his feet. And Mindfreak will lock in three.
Yeah, FlyQuest still keeping these rounds expensive, though. Only two players surviving in round two and three for Mindfreak, so only bringing a couple of rifles through each time is going to chip down the economy a little bit as FlyQuest head into this first gun round. Orbs coming out for Ali. He is our player to watch. And it's going to be an interesting test to see Pain going up against him head-to-head. It's kind of like the up-and-coming Orb up versus the established Orb up. But at least in this round, it's going to be rifles across the board. Quick wall of smokes. Once again, Tux just sending it straight into secret. Alistair's already rotated down to AWP. So we'll see if he gets an opportunity to find a pick here.
Whoa. That timing was crazy. Tux just across the line. Here's the scope. Sees that shoulder coming around the corner and gets every advantage he needs to.
The Annex and Windows.
Mayhem. already at secret, Mitch. He's been getting there so quick every round.
Yeah, he was doing this in the game yesterday. Dexter, how has he gotten away with two through the side of the smoke there? Lot of damage. No, actually, you know what? He was up in heaven. It wasn't even the player with the A1S. They got baited. Vex'ar continuing to aggress. He can see the bomb. They know that there was another player on outside here. They can hear that nade from Tux, who's already been spotted down in lower. So you can see FlyQuest mobilizing around outside, looking for good angles. In the meanwhile, Gump trying to flank in through radio.
Nice peek. Vex'ar climbing. And Tux goes out into a wide line. Everyone's swinging off contact, but it wasn't even needed. Inns takes the last pick, and FlyQuest finally get on the board here on their first real gun round.
Dexter's 8-3, man. Popping the hell off. It was a fantastic start for Mindfreak. The pick into lower like that is exactly what you were looking for. Inns and Dexter combining on outside, though, to clean up Mindfreak as they try to meet up with Tux and make some impact happen from that pick in lower. Surprised there's not more investment from Mindfreak here. Payne definitely had enough for a rifle armor if he wanted here a rifle, but I think he's saving for an AWP instead, maybe. Ricky swinging open the door. He's been playing really good lately. He had a pop-off game on Nuke against Art of War yesterday, Ricky.
Yeah. Well, he's going to be on the right side of that historical event. M4 Retrieve tosses it across. Might have been the bomb though. Vex'ar M4 picked up. And it's looking like there won't be too much more damage done this round. Tux gets found. And 4 survive for FlyQuest.
Yeah, they're really starting to build a strong economy on this CT side. It's going to take a little bit of time for Mindfreak to work their way back into this game. Haven't quite built up that loss bonus to maximum yet. But they're going in with another gun round here. See what they're going to come up with. 4 rifles retained here for FlyQuest. They lost the AWP on Alistair earlier, but now they've replaced it. So once again, AWP coming out for him. Payne, instead of buying a hero rifle, has opted to get the AWP into round 6. Front door smoke. A lot of smokes on outside as well for Mindfreak. Payne's out over there looking for a pick. Smoke blown open by Dexter, trying to make it difficult for Mindfreak to come out door here.
Gump playing very cheeky here at Outers. Liaz still ready for the swing, but won't be able to hit the shots he needs to. So we're straight back to a 4v4. Dexter, however, has slipped the needle. We'll find the bomb, and we'll see how FlyQuest decide to operate, knowing that they've got full control of the objective. Sun's out, guns out, Tux ready, and aware that maybe there's someone else playing for the bomb.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, with Dexter definitely seeing the bomb, you're expecting more CTs to mobilize in through lobby side when that much space has been taken. In's the tip of his little head spotted out by Gump. Ricky punished by Alistair in from elbow side. Bomb finally picked up by Tux. The T's very split up right now. Gump was spotted earlier on. They don't know where Payne was or the fact that he had an AWP. He hasn't fired a shot this round yet. And Tux last spotted backside of lobby. You can see Alistair looking to clear lobby from radio room, and both of FlyQuest trying to take some fights towards Annex and maybe some control of HUD or Squeaky in the mid round here.
Their Verdins go down towards site. Gump making noise, drawing attention back to his position, but In seems to know what's up. Very ready for a swing for Kane here. Oh, but the AWP gets the better of him. 2 little bursts, don't get the job done. Vex'ar eyes on heaven, can't spray it down. And we are going to see full A-site control coming through just in time for Mindfreak. Ali, he's in the wrong place, and he's looking to save the AWP for the next.
It's good stuff from Mindfreak. Been a bit critical of some of the rounds where they run down the clock and run out of time, don't give themselves enough breathing room, but that was very, very well worked. Very patient with the outside control that they had, re-recovering the bomb and making sure that, you know, initially they were so split up. You had Gump up on heaven. Tux had to go back for the bomb. Payne was on outside. And they take the time that they need to actually rework the map and peek into uppers together and just have good spacing and be able to trade those two players. You know, if you're not on top of your spacing against FlyQuest, they will definitely be punishing you for that. But Mindfreak, credit where credit's due. 3 rifles surviving here. Going up 4-2 on the T side of Nuke and putting some pretty serious pressure on FlyQuest's economy now. Probably will have to be at least a single drop, if not a double drop from Alistair here to towards Vexide and Dexter. But following this with the 2.4 loss bonus, there is pretty big reset potential for both teams, actually. Yeah, soft reset on the T side and a soft reset for CTs as well. Are they going to buy? Yeah, I was assuming the double drop was going to come through, and it will at the last second here.
Very excited to see where all of these ESL Pro Tour events are going to be held, because some currently don't have any locations. And if you guys want to catch up with that, jump on over to the ESLCS Twitter and you can see the announcement that went live between the start of the show and this game.
If you guys could just go and spam on that post, where is IEM Fall going to be?
Yes.
As many comments as we can get saying exactly that would be fantastic. 4-on-5 for FlyQuest. After losing Alistair on outside, punished by Pain. He got kind of robbed in the opening portions of this round. I'm surprised Tux didn't go down. He does get traded by Vexide though, and Dexter swinging out. FlyQuest staying proactive and trying to re-clear outside with numbers, but still only end up in a 3-on-3 without too much information.
Yeah, let's see if Gump's going to be able to sway his way through site. Finds a whole lot of space here. And Inzerberg right up to heaven. Straight to the grave though. Falling a whole long way. Dexter low towards main. And he's just going to wait that smoke out before trying to get any more damage done. Some Pain still with full lobby control, so they don't have to worry about any flank coming through. It's just all down to when Dexter wants to go for the timing here. Liaz, I believe, is silencing what he's seeing. All eyes on the annex push. And Dexter is going to deal with Liaz. Beautifully played in the post plant. Mindfreak are looking incredibly good considering how early the game is.
Yeah, Gump's on a tear as well. That's a good thing about Mindfreak. Like, honestly, I've seen every player on this team have a POF map. This time it's Gump. And in general, the T side is being very well worked. I'm especially impressed how they're navigating a lot of these mid rounds. Like, we're pretty consistently ending up in these 3-on-3 situations that Mindfreak are getting the better of FlyQuest, out rotating them, finding good space, good timings on the map, which is very positive to see. And that was the reset round earned by Mindfreak. Now they go into an anti-eco with pretty good money on the T side here. A 1-4. Gump's been left on the lurk. He's very comfortable in this position. Off angle from Liaz does earn him a dig, but not going to be able to finish off Gump, and Tux finds the entry down and lower as well.
Not bad, not bad. One man disadvantage for FlyQuest. AK retrieved, and Vexite's still going to have a sniff over towards ramp. I like this as well, the reapproach in through the holes, spacing's good. Ricky disregarding that Inz could be there, but he will double check after the first pick, and it is clean again. 4 alive for Mindfreak. Look at the money. It is building round after round here.
Yeah, this is exactly what you need. Not only are they up 6-2, but they have the economy to continue front-running this, the rest of this T-side, right? Like, could really line themselves up for like a 9-3 pretty dominant scoreline, but I don't know how much longer FlyQuest is just going to keep letting this happen and keep letting themselves kind of get out-rotated in the mid-round. Like, I think they can start to switch on a little bit now. A lot more lobby control and emphasis here for Mindfreak, looking to switch things up. Pain with a full belt to util, preparing the uppers pop.
Is going everywhere. Dexter going to be able to snatch them away, but the crossfire is going to pay dividends for sure. Pain, tip down to half, underarm molly. And Mindfreak, the change in pace is expected. FlyQuest, tear him a new one.
Yeah, swatted the way pretty easily. I actually don't know where those flashes were connecting on, because like, we saw Pain throwing them. The Observer super on top of the util usage, and then I didn't see any CTs blind. I don't know about you, Mac, but they looked like they were just staring at Heart from Rafter.
Yeah,
and having a pretty easy time locking that down, even without any real counter util, you know? It wasn't like there was that many seconds between the flashes going in and the T scaling out. So, Yeah, I don't know. Maybe not throwing the right flashes for the right positions in terms of, you know, which skylight and all that kind of stuff, or the timing was a little off, or the flashes weren't thrown right. Not really sure. Paint's trying to hold on to the AWP, and that's what I was talking about, man. Like, only so many rounds in a row you're going to see FlyQuest kind of get battered. Now they're switching on in this gun round. They can't afford to lose too many guns here, though. They have no cash to replace them.
Was it Payne throwing the flashes?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to watch on Face It Watch, and in about 5 minutes, well, probably 3 minutes now, I can tell you where the flashes went.
Wow. It's you, huh?
Mm-hmm. Look at me.
You're a bit of a gamer.
It's like a live demo, guys. If you watch on Face It Watch, you can watch whatever POVs you want. If you are a Josh fan, also Inns W's in the chat, get ESL to add that as an emote for 7TV. Great emote, by the way. You can just watch from his POV the whole time. Turn us on, turn us off. You don't need to listen to the casters. Screw the casters. Get rid of us. Just watch pure Inns Gaming or any of your favorite players. We'll see what Payne does. And, Ricky. Thought he had the spawn. Took it. Tried to get the pick. Missed opportunity. And reveals the location of that AWP for the wine break as FlyQuest are hunting for a pick.
Yep. Wall of smoke finally going to be finished up on outside here. Obscuring the vision, maybe giving Tux an opportunity to try to cross. Gump forcing his way through the elbow smoke. Had a seconds window of an opportunity. This time, Alistair has a much better timing down into secret, and that is a free as hell kill. Mind Freak not getting some of the breaks that they were getting earlier on. See how they go converting a 4-on-5.
Ricky, funny Dexter getting a little overzealous over towards door.
Refresh on the door smoke. Gonna halt Mind Freak for now for another 15 seconds or so. They're gonna be going into top site in the last 20. Alistair rotating over towards ramp. He's had a lot of impact this round. Ricky prepping the execute.
Molly. Dealing with the top of heart, smoke's everywhere, and it's just Inns over the wards. Default, they got to worry about, they want to go for the drop, but they're a little worried to go down dry, get caught throwing the flashes, and FlyQuest, they stopped them from making their way to the lower site. That was a beautiful setup from them, but misread from Mind Freak, not expecting there to be the upper stack so late in the round.
Great movement around the map as well from Ali. Isolating and picking off the lurk on both sides. You often see Gump as the lobby lurk and Tux as the lurker down secret. He's gotten both of those players, and you can kind of be ready for the pack once you deal with both of them.
All right, they're on Glocks, Mitch. I know this could be a cool round because they bought utility, but I was just watching Vexite, knew that there was two flashes. He was ready for those two flashes from Payne. Played anti perfectly, flicked the round, came back, looked like he wasn't blind, but he should have been. And him and Dexter, you know, similar things. Just had that full solid crossfire setup. So that's what happened the other end. And I learned that thanks to Face It Watch. Kind of crazy.
Turns out FlyQuest have played against an upper's execute before. And it's starting to brim with confidence now. That was a complete dismantling of what was a little bit of a half buy from Mind Freak. Was a great start to this half. 6-2. That scoreline is looking a little different now. FlyQuest will buy into this last round. Mind Freak going to use attack to try to secure themselves a 7-5 here. A little bit light on the cash for some of these players, so going to have to decide if they want to go down to Galil for the full belts of util or go a little lighter and get some AKs. It's good to see Mind Freak playing well on their map pick, though. It is something that I'm noticing at the moment, though, with some of these newer teams coming together and how much parity there is in the scene right now. I don't really feel like a lot of teams have a very well-defined or fleshed-out map pool. You're seeing a lot of teams just going one-for-one, winning their map picks. And I think it's something that, you know, I'm looking to see if these rosters stick together and how they look to, like, further develop and work on the rest of their map pool. Because, I mean, perfect example, Mind Freak's Nuke is sick, Art of War's Inferno is sick, but when you look at some of the other maps, they're definitely not having the same strength across the entirety of the pool.
Oh, Ali. Very ready for the cross into lower, but how many men is he ready for? Dex catches the timing all the way to the back of the door. This time, things are about to get real awkward. There we go. Ali going to be able to strike again in the hole. And meanwhile, Dexter, or Ricky rather, finding ins and outer. Things getting real crazy because the bomb's down lower. We've got a man at top secret and FlyQuest just trying to figure out where they want to go. Vexite goes the right direction, catching Ricky on the reroute. And Tux just hoping he could hear something. Vexite spots him in the vent there. And he will take it 6-6 at the half.
Yeah, really good half. Saw from both teams. Yeah, Mind Freak. I think they've gotten a decent little run on the T side there, securing themselves a fair few rounds. I think FlyQuest, though, it's the comeback that we kind of expected from them. And honestly, I think they're looking pretty good to close out this game on the T side. But we'll see what Mind Freak has for us in that second half.
We are back with a beautiful second half. We flipped sides. FlyQuest now on the offensive. Not globally, though. Although some might say differently. And Mind Freak on the defense on that CT side. Ooh, Jay getting frisky with it. Gonna hit a couple of hops on his teammate's head. But does it change the timing? I don't think that. Let's look at my FlyQuest. All eyes on outers.
Yep. Big moves on outside. Flash goes up over the top, which is going to allow a cheeky little time. Might not be expected by Tux at all. Gets caught with his pants down. FlyQuest have taken full control of lowers. No rotations from Mindfreak yet. They're a little out of position. Trying to make something happen on Megaton, and Liaz is harassing them. Bomb has been
planted. Yeah, they're really focused on trying to find Liaz here. Two members invested. Spotted. Liaz now knows that he's getting swung on. Big damage onto Ricky. Oh, and it's all over the bloody place. They'll get him eventually, but in the 4v4, time has already ticked away. About 30 seconds left to get this retake going. And there is no kit from what I can see here. So they've got to get a wriggle on three. Looking to smash their way out of Mega here. Payne just calls it. That's going to be that. Saving. Keeping the, what, two untouched sets of Kev across to the next. Make it one.
Alistair ruining them. They're really trying to go for the hunt here. That's a nice kill for Alistair. Going one for one. In's going down to the bomb. Vexite very low from the bomb as well. That should have been a kill for Gump, but Vexite strafing well. Nice little pre-aim around the side of the outside box there. And it's going to be FlyQuest winning that T-pistol. Mindfreak. There's a reason why they wanted to save all of that Kevlar, get some easier upgrades. They are going to be forcing into this one. Got a scout and a couple dualies, couple MP9s, and a lot of util here. FlyQuest though, majority Galil armor, just the one MAC-10, not really playing too many games. Let's see if Payne can be a bit of a difference maker with the scope on outside.
He's hunting. Deep smokes, set of two, and FlyQuest using them appropriately. Okay, gets broken, but works better for FlyQuest. Scout gonna be recycled in the hands of Gump. He won't get any damage off just yet, but he is getting pressured. Dexed up, sneaking his way forward. Gump actually going into the T-smoke. I don't mind this move. Oh, but he's missed jumping up onto the keg. The barrels might have been able to find himself an angle there. The noise might have sealed the deal. Smoke fading. Dexter hunting for him.
Knife. No.
Squeezes out every second, and now we got a 3v5. Things looking even harder for Mindfreak. Dexter getting pumped here. Okay, MP9s bring it back to the 3v3 like that. Ricky pushing into lobby, dealing with the lurker. And now we got a 3v3 on that B-site retake.
Yeah, Mindfreak's pretty out of position, though. Again, no kit. May have even been a situation where they could be considering a save. One for one, clearing out that place, player close, Megaton. But after plant versus Windows and T-Con with one player this low, I honestly think you should be saving the Galils. They're going to go for it. Flash goes into window, and that was easy as you like from Vexite, cleaning up Texture on 8 HP, and Ricky's not even going to go for it. Like, could have had two sets of Galil and armor, but yeah, unfortunate. FlyQuest gonna pick up another round on this T side, and this is where, like, you've seen so many games like this, you know? A lot of teams can have a good couple of rounds or a good half against FlyQuest, you know, but pretty quickly the game can start slipping through your fingers once, you know, they get rolling.
Good halves in the chat. Pay your respects to Mindfreak's good half. But yeah, if they can continue to whittle away at FlyQuest economy, we could see a swing around. We could see Mindfreak come straight back into the half. But I don't think that's going to be this round. Economy suggests that. Smoke on a squeaky. Texas should be hearing everything over towards outers. We got the El Clasico nip wall. Looks like FlyQuest are going straight into secret for the most part. Dexter had a little gap to play with there. Decides to go into main instead. We'll take the fight with the USP. And he knows he's winning that every day of the week. Ricky, low. With his aggression down towards lowers. Okay, are they expecting the next man? They will be. Text up, dealt with. I thought the MP9 might have had some chalk on it. But it's just going to be the timing from Gump to get more damage. Gump tucks in the vent. Oh, flash allows him to go aggressive. And he runs out of bullets in the clip of the Mackie. And now it's all up to Liaz on 17 points of health to make this one happen. Gump fake closing double doors. Liaz makes his way back to the cleared out site. A whole minute to play with. But wants that plant money.
Yeah, nice and open plant for him. Ricky very low. Gump, the USP, not going to be a big issue, especially because he's picked up an AK now. But I was going to say, Liaz very low. He's picked the timing so well. This man's game sense is perfect. He's heard the jump up the vent as well. Knows exactly where Ricky is. This HE could be huge. Gonna tap it. Liaz just faking the sound, knowing that Ricky doesn't have a kit. It's gonna be very difficult to stick the plant here. Ricky trying to get the pre-fire on, knowing how low Liaz is, but Liaz has played that absolutely perfectly.
Yeah, pat yourself on the back. I thought maybe there was a world where we'd see that nade action coming through, but it is just going to be the Galil carried across again. But look, long game, damage is done. Mind Freak just chipping away again and again at FlyQuest economy. There was, what, two alive in the previous round, one alive in this one. And this round had no right getting so close. Imagine if there was just a couple of extra bullets in that MAC-10 mag. Oh, also, Mitch, I got, let's just say yelled at, corrected is a better word, by an American. I called magazine a clip. Apparently a clip is not a magazine. They got really angry at me for using bad terminology, and I apologize for all the clip, unenjoyers, or real gun enjoyers. Ricky? Mm. Be able to lock down that hall's control, and ooh, ramp is going to be put in the hands of FlyQuest.
It is. Got a man advantage as well. Two players down in lower here for Mind Freak, wanting to contest it, and without too much information, FlyQuest cutting sound. Tux is going looking for Alistair here, who's switched on enough to deal with him. Anticipating the second player as well. Molly gonna zone Ricky back. Payne is still alive at CT vent, and he's getting collapsed upon. Oh. By multiple players, able to hit the shot on Dexter, but this is way too much for him to watch here, and in swinging out Heaven will get that done. Alistair still has a little bit of an inkling that Ricky was down in towards lower, and it's going to be a nice safe plant for Heaven in the 3-on-1. Looking like Ricky's just going to save again here.
Yeah, he gets that A1S in hand. And probably won't see any more action. FlyQuest, they need to worry about their own economy, their own finances, really. If any more damage gets done to them this round, again, they'll be on breaking point moving into the next. And look, even though they are getting the rounds, that's super important, but so is, you know, making sure that you've got enough money to stay in the bloody game. And that's what they're doing this time. No worries about Ricky. He saved guns last couple of rounds and it hasn't won Mind Freak any rounds, so they're just going to let him do the same thing again. And there is going to be enough money to drop two M4A1Ss to his teammates. So I'd say you're probably buying. Okay, he's bought an AWP. Yep.
Yeah, AWP purchase. Payne can drop an M4 as well. Just goes without you, Tilt. Ricky? Okay, all right, they're gonna align their money at 2k apiece and give themselves a decent shot at winning the round. Ricky gonna hold on to the AWP. They're just trying to min-max the economy because they don't have as much reset potential with so many FlyQuest players surviving. Tux, he sees the spam diving forward with the MP9. It's a missed opportunity. Ricky's found a pick in the meanwhile onto Inns. So we're on a 4-on-4. Gump spotting the pixel line. Gonna throw down a reactive smoke and try to get to work with the 5-7 here.
Weird little CS2 physics. Smoke, of course, getting slightly affected by the movement after clicking to throw. Ricky. Oh, missed opportunities, getting burnt out and dealt with it. Heaven can't keep on going back for more, and FlyQuest, they were allowed the warm up and they are starting to assert their dominance here in the second half of Nuke. Mind Freak yet to find a round, and I don't know if they're going to on the CT side.
Yeah, it's looking that way. Might just be saving these two rifles and conceding the 11th to FlyQuest. Like, some of the rounds have been getting close-ish, though. You know, it's not like FlyQuest is winning that many rounds with four or five players surviving. Like, Mind Freak is always trading a couple of kills and chipping in a few here and there, but FlyQuest is pretty convincingly winning these mid to late rounds and closing out the post plants. Off angle, text up, trying to keep the AK alive. That's a freebie onto Vexite. Money is not actually great here on the T side, so losing a lot of guns here for FlyQuest. I don't know if that wall is bangable. I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen anyone try and shoot through that. Regardless, though, two rifles safe for Mindfreak. They're going to call an attack timeout. Took a lot of guns away from FlyQuest. You can see the effect that that has on the T side economy here. 1400 loss bonus means that this will be a soft reset on three players of FlyQuest, 2.9 and below. Alistair will have like 5.4. So I think if Mindfreak can win this round, they can pick up themselves up a seventh, and then maybe they're going against like a light buy with a hero rifle. That's a little bit of an easier round to put together, perhaps. And then, you know, there's a little bit, you know, there's still more work to be done, but they have a path to kind of close the score a little bit. Question really kind of remains, though, whether FlyQuest is even going to let them do that. Like you said, it has been a flawless T-side so far. Don't see that stopping anytime soon.
More aggression, FlyQuest forcing their way out the door. Smoke CT is quite ready, but also quite bloody blind. Tuck's gonna be able to regain eyesight just in time. And we got a 3-0 trade coming through. Big damage on a Gump, big damage on a Tux, but no one securing a pick just yet. We'll see if Dexter can maybe get their way back into the game after lurking into help.
Yeah, I mean, that's just the thing though. FlyQuest are known domestically for winning rounds just like this one, winning ridiculous like 2-on-5s. That's not going to work this time, though. Ricky, hopping off the ladder. That's a freebie onto Dexter. Ali, 1-on-5. It's a question of damage, really. First kill's very clean, though. He's going to need a couple more just like that. Tux and Gump are both quite low. Smoke into the middle of the site. He's going to molly windows so no one can peek him from there. Taps the plant. Trying to bait out one of these CTs to peek through decon or through windows. No one is going to actually commit to the peek just yet. Just kind of pressuring him. Testing him from multiple angles, waiting for the right timing for everyone to get there and peek out together. And that was sensible stuff from Mindfreak. Low player goes forward, spots out his position, Dexter with the full HP there to trade. And they're going to keep three players surviving. They already had some pretty decent money on one or two of the players. So with no bomb plant, they have earned kind of this weird soft reset. The money's a little bit all over the place for FlyQuest. I'm interested to see what they're going to do here. I would definitely expect, you know, a hero AK and, like, yeah, just light investment from everyone else, which is exactly what we're going to get.
Yeah.
From FlyQuest. So this is the easier round that Mindfreak need to make sure that it can close.
Okay. Cooking. Tux. Able to deal with that aggression, but FlyQuest already getting members down lower. Ricky. Fast on the rotation, gets there in time, drops the bomb, does everything he needs to, and more reload getting through just in time. And that Glock is not going to finish off Tux. Does get him down to one. Very unfortunate. Full backside.
It's clean round. Mindfreak have got the economy to try to fight for this game with. Money's still not good for FlyQuest. They needed that bomb plan in lower. That was actually huge that Ricky was able to deny that. Look at this buy. It's going to be pretty poor, honestly. Galil's in armor and still missing a lot of utility on the T side. There is a very good chance Mindfreak could try to push this into double digits now. They've got better util, better weapons. They just need to make sure they're converting this one. Wall of smoke across outside and over to Annex. A lot of util invested early on. Gump, I love that. Pushing through the progression smoke, front door, getting in the face of FlyQuest. Payne also finds a pick. Ricky peeking in through lobby. Mindfreak are playing with full confidence, just running at FlyQuest in the early portions of this round.
Things getting a little bit awkward for FlyQuest. Where's that bomb? Is that a door? Okay, over to the
radio.
Yeah. Couldn't see it. Ricky was standing on the damn thing.
Hate it when
Ricky does
that.
Looking good for Mindfreak to...
Classic Ricky.
Classic Ricky. Stopping the information from flowing.
He's having another good game on New Kid today. Him and Gump.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know, bro. Like, you know, I've seen Ricky playing for 10 years now, more than 10 years now, you know? I have no more expectations for Ricky. And he's still playing well on Mindfuck lately, so... Yeah, I don't know.
Someone said that Tux had 100% headshot ratio. I'm going to check if that's still up there. Yeah, so when he got 9 kills, he was. So he's got 4 kills since then. We are living in the future, of course. So we'll see if that 100% headshot ratio is still there in about 4 minutes or so. But for the moment, it's just Liaz looking to cause some financial damage to the CTs, and he will barely do that. One gun taken. AK taken out of his hands. I don't think it was after time.
No. He's fine.
And that'll be that.
Great economy for Mindfreak. And it's they've earned themselves another reset on FlyQuest here. Like, this CT side comeback is going exactly how you'd want it to be going for Mindfreak.
FlyQuest are getting this one over and done with, seeing how many members they can get down the vent. The answer is 2. But Ricky here, ready. Good bowling. Finishes off Dexter with the HE while using the AK for the other bit. And Mindfreak, just like that, they've broken the economy of FlyQuest in the last couple of rounds. Managed to stack on, what's that, 4? Like, it's kind of nothing. And FlyQuest feeling fallible.
Yeah, they finally do have enough money and max loss bonus to get these good buys together, though. Max util on the T side. This is where you'd expect FlyQuest to close, but Mindfreak, with how cleanly they've been stringing this comp together, they'll have more than enough money to get gun rounds on gun rounds to really try to fight for this game. A lot of util invested early on from both teams. Pain aggressing into lobby once again, trying to change things up, trying to catch FlyQuest a little bit off guard. The rifle going forward. Tux, it's just not quite a good enough adjustment to catch Inns there, who pops a little bit of a shot through the wall, but it's still a man disadvantage for Mindfreak.
Okay. Dexter manages to get all the way to secret without being spotted. Ricky, in the meanwhile, is taken out. Great shots from the rifles of FlyQuest. They just slow things down. Expect this kind of over-aggression to come towards them. Pain going to be locked into the corner. Gump needs to pretty much do this all himself. The molly finishes off Pain. And now in the 4v1, there's that bomb going. Oh, it's in lobby. Managed to catch it, but won't stop the flank from happening. Over towards Heartside. That's going to be 12 on the board. And just when you thought Mindfreak might have been in with a shot, FlyQuest put themselves at least onto overtime point.
Yeah. 2 gun rounds in a row is doable for Mindfreak, though. Definitely could push us through to OT. Double AWP's going to come out. Let's see if that's a change-up that benefits Mindfreak here. They end up in a retake scenario early on, or in some kind of uppers rush, though. They're definitely going to be regretting that purchase. Again. Early util exchange. All the smokes across. Outside Texter pushed off of this door line. Maybe finished off by the nade. Opening pick goes the way of FlyQuest. Again, Vexite further extending that advantage until Ricky finds a pick on outside.
Uh-oh. Pain's in the wrong spot to be using this weapon. Can't skewer 2 on. Good movement to get away from that one. Able to reposition. T's going damn close. Good for the trade. But a 2-for-1. You'll take that as Pain. And now we got FlyQuest just smashing their way to lower, at least Ali is. That bomb's still on Liaz over towards lobby. He's worried about any aggression. There's been a lot of that out of Mindfreak. And Ricky needs to be the man to find the info here.
Yeah, Ricky and Gump, the standouts for Mindfreak so far in this game. Ali spotting out the player on Windows side. Gonna flash him off the line. In the meanwhile, Liaz taking this into his own hands, walking into upper with the bomb. Gump was on Heaven side. Steps have been heard by Alistair, waiting for Ricky. It's 2 cases of timing in uppers and lower that will decide round.
Gump is still here. to stop that bomb from going down, and Mind Freak buy themselves some room to breathe. FlyQuest, they've got money, fortunately for them. Valley goes for the AWP. It's going to be a little rough for Liaz and Inz to try to get AKs on the board. Where's this buy going? Looks like Inz is happy to go down to the Tech 9 to get that extra utility. Ellie gets that AWP online, and Mind Freak, they have everything they need and more to stop them.
Yeah. Maintaining that double AWP as well. Side. Got some outside smokes early on here. Payne on the line with the AWP. Alistair's over here. Spots him out. Gonna walk around the other side. Wait for the smokes to bloom, so not even wanted to take that opening kill. Dexter has crept behind enemy lines. The easiest kill in the side of Payne's head here. Two players in Annex. Nade in hand for Gump, but still not blowing open that smoke. And FlyQuest have made it across to Secret with a man advantage.
Yeah, Ricky very worried about getting flanked from the yard as well now. After losing their warehouse player, Vexite, ready for the aggression, deals with it, and it looks like this may be all she wrote. Dexter is an upper player, and that bomb's going lower. This is looking awkward now. Dexter about to flick around. Oh, the bomb's coming back this way. Ain't no way. Ain't no bloody way. That's going to be the bomb on the ground. Dexter has just big-brained this. Can he take it to OT in a 1v5? That would be a goddamn miracle. Vexite jumping onto the ladder could have been heard.
Inz has got an AWP here, and he's coming through outside. So there's actually two players with AWPs in this 1-on-3. Only Vexite with a rifle, and he's low. That kind of makes it more doable for Dexter.
Oh, look at coordination. Dexter!
No way!
No!
Oh, man, had it on a platter. Bro. Almost got that one done.
Imagine, bro. 1v5 against FlyQuest. That would be Dexter well and truly back. I mean, he kind of is. Didn't have the best game up until that point, but to push us to OT with a 1v5, it was very, very close. Hats off to him. And hats off to my freak in general. I mean, they played... Sorry, guys. The teams were rearing to get into this after a very, very tight game of Nuke. So we're going to head straight into Inferno. Is the upper bracket final here of ECL Season 48 for OS. And this game, going to qualify one of these teams in towards ESL Pro League. FlyQuest just racking up Pro League qualifications like it's nothing. Because I think heading through onto Inferno, they should be favored to get the 2-0 here. But I was still impressed with how Mind Freak played on Nuke previously. They played a pretty good game. Let's see how they go on this map.
Yeah, let's have a look. It's going to be a big old look because I'm excited to see an upset. I want Mind Freak to bring everything they got, tell us what they're made of, give us some kind of quality. Right? Maybe high quality, maybe low quality. Maybe dragging down the level they want to play at, but FlyQuest, they've been at the bottom, they've been at the top. They played at every bloody level, and let's see what kind of Counter-Strike we're going to be getting out of Inferno here. Looking like there's going to be a lot of banana control. FlyQuest going straight on up. Ricky caught jumping and caught with his pants down.
Yeah, that's going to be an opening pick for FlyQuest. Tux solo on the A side. Trying to peek out on the timing, even up the numbers, spots at least one player coming back to bracket side, and he's going to stick around here. Oh, hell of a shot onto Dexter. Very ballsy to be peeking up top mid like that. But when you got the USP, you know you're good for a couple little timings. And he just keeps re-peeking. No one's punishing him. May as well. He's going to go for it again. This time into apartments.
Ooh, hunting for it. Up dig. Upsight, full control for FlyQuest and Mind Freak. If they can maybe catch Vexite here lurking at mid, then there can be a better opportunity. Man advantage for the retake now and plenty of time to do so, but we are going to see that time not being waited for. Dexter hungry to get a few more kills on the board there. Pain jiggling, waiting for that smoke towards long side. Flash forward, Molly in, does a whole bunch of damage, and the turtle up on site looks good until it doesn't. Liaz needs to do it all himself in the 1v2, and he's gonna. Oh. Text up, gets that shot off just in time. Big shots out of Mind Freak, and they're gonna take a CT pistol and put themselves in the pole position to kick off map 2.
I thought FlyQuest had it done, not only finding Ricky for free right off the rip, but also the crossfire and the perfectly timed Molly onto Dig side should have made it impossible for Mind Freak to get back in there, but they find a way to do it, and they've started out well here. See if they can maintain that. I think Tux, you know, being such a pest at top middle and bringing the numbers back, made a bit of a difference, and big retake coming in for Mind Freak, so 1-0 for them. But as you often do see, Mac, the force buy after the T-bomb plant for FlyQuest is going to come through. So you've got another test to pass here for Mind Freak.
Ooh, okay. Looking a little bit awkward there at top mid. Vexlite finds an opening. Famous gameplay from Gump looking for the apps control. Nice shot from Ali. And the A-site defenses get torn to shreds. Gump just looking to play his life and buy some time for rotations. Moto smoke slows down the reinforcements, or at least splits him up. Ali running away with the AK. Oh, and rightfully so. Yeah, shots off like that. Wants more damage done, but he'll lose his head. In's hoping to retrieve the rifle, but he won't be allowed to with Gump going over to Boiler side. It is going to be the full wrap back in through Dig. Tux not even thinking about going for the upgrade. Tech9 doesn't get it done, and now we're down to the 2v2. Time's ticked away. Tux with Kit in play. And Dexter, oh, at this range, big damage on the Tux. One bullet will knock him down a notch, and it will. Vexite, big 3k, three piece for the rounds. And FlyQuest, the force buy, works wonderfully.
Another nice try on the retake from Mind Freak, but FlyQuest is getting way too much done in the opening portions of this round. Force Fly works out a treat from them. Some pretty significant losses along the way, but we'll see how they go on their own anti-force. Pain going to hold on to some extra cash for an AWP. Rest of the boys buying up as you would kind of expect them to. Gonna drop off a cache of util over towards the backside of B there. So gonna lean on Tux to basically play B by himself while they four stack A. Dexter's eating a nade early on here. But FlyQuest sitting up behind their progression smoke towards top of banana and just keeping an eye out on the rest of the map. There's the flash to half wall. Inns will secure control of sandbags for now and force out the first smoke from Tux.
Slow approach. FlyQuest expecting Mind Freak to make a move. But with the four-man setup at top mid, you know it's just going to be that trap play. Tux just continuing to rotate the smokes on B. And hopefully push FlyQuest over towards mid. But they've seen this before. And it doesn't look like they're going to fall for it.
Another smoke here for Tux. Gonna buy another 18 seconds, but that's his last one. No, the HE's there for Dexter, so they can blow open this smoke, and they will. Tux spotted out close as well, cleared by Inns. Only going one for one, and FlyQuest, I think, will probably just save all of these pistols, I'd imagine, and all play for exits. That is, part of CS2. You wait out the majority of those smokes, but as long as you've got an HE, if you've got a go, you can still go late into B like that nowadays. Used to kind of be a death sentence in Go, but here in CS2, can clear a lot of those close positions with a nicely placed HE. And I think FlyQuest are quite happy about how that's gone.
Still early days, and still with a good chance in the next round for Mind Freak. they run the exact same thing again. Are we going to go for the five-man stack? Are we going to put the pieces towards B instead? Let's see. Let's find out together. FlyQuest just refreshing that utility. Plenty of money in the bank after that round.
Yeah, going to keep building up that economy. Mindfreak, as we mentioned, just holding on to the pistols, trying to do some more down this round. They haven't really been slowing down the T-side economy too much and won't be buying up till round 5. Cheap ducks. Once again, catches Dexter pretty heavily. He has solo in towards apps, but not going to get caught by the app setup again. Blowing open the smoke has worked out a trick for FlyQuest over on the B side of the map. They've lost an A1S in second mid. Ricky, last one here on B, and does pretty well to go 1-for-1, but still FlyQuest going to get that B side control and get the plant down pretty early here.
Yeah, of course, been maxing that $100 kill reward by dying to the Molotov. He was thinking about that for sure. Jump now, last alive, and the banana push gets mopped up. Mindfreak a little bit too slow to make that one happen. The rifle they retrieved, unfortunately, couldn't get more damage done, but it is going to be guns ahoy for Mindfreak because they've lost 3 in a row now. Plenty of money in the bank, plenty of utility, smokes for everyone, but a solid round at a FlyQuest means they will be in a very good position considering they won that round after the pistol. Just showing again that the plant money goes a whole long way on those pistol rounds, even if you don't win them. Mindfreak now with their best chance yet at a second round. Oh, Molly making things awkward here. Ricky gonna be able to stand behind it. The spread, is it late? No. We'll be able to survive. They're going all guns blazing towards Banana in spraying, waiting for a reswing, but he won't be able to escape this time. Ali with the AWP in hand. People coming. Goes fishing. But he won't find anything this time. Oh, through the smoke he does. And just like that, Mindfreak have thrown away the man advantage. Open committee.
Doing his best from Moto, but his best is not good enough here. Vexart is 9-1 right now. Alistair bringing the bomb over. No kit for Ricky, and he's pretty far behind the 8-ball, but Alistair not really feeling comfortable enough forcing things through the smoke. He'll take some extra time off the clock. Ricky knows the plant's on A now. But just going to play the exits. Hold on to the AK for the next round. FlyQuest continuing to kind of dominate the way we'd expect them to on the T side. They have picked Inferno for the longest time. I don't think that there's a more comfortable position FlyQuest could be than starting T side of Inferno. They've probably done it hundreds of times now.
Any extra damage to come through here? Terrorists win. Doesn't seem to be the case. Good damage to the T economy, all things considered. But the problem is they had a couple of clean bloody rounds, and that means that there is a long way to go for Mindfreak to win the financial game here. And this round ain't going to be it. Probably not. We did say this on Nuke and they almost won what was like the weirdest eco half buy ever. And it's even weirder here, but 5.7s, MP9s can go a whole long way. A map like Inferno. Ooh. Playing a dangerous game at mid. Text up, gets the info on the AWP's position. Great nade. Over to Olaf.
So Tux's nade again. The dude's gotten like 50 plus damage every round with an HE. The totem pole boost. Looking real nice. Ricky. Gonna punish Dexter up over the top of the smoke. And this is where this half buy looking more and more threatening over time. Bomb still at T stairs. Flash goes up onto the line. Ricky spotting out at least one player there, but not really pushing the issue too much. Here's the brackets take. He has not spotting out Pain close. Sandbag player flushed out, but Ricky continues to deliver with that hero AK that he saved in the last round.
I like this A setup from Mind Freak. Just going double apps. Rewrapping back around, looking to maybe catch a timing. And they might just do that. Oh, Pain spotted. I don't know that there's going to be two players in apps, though. And that gives him a lot of space to get this one down. Great swing at top mid. Ian's not quite ready for it. And that's going to be an AK. Well, maybe passable. I don't know if Tux. Yeah, they're going to go back for that one later. All eyes on the retake. Two T's rather. Someone's DC. And, oh, Vexlarch is going to be tapping at range, which works for the first one. Liaz needs to spray down many men, but that ain't happening. And we got Mind Freak with the mixed bite getting their second round on the board, which may flip the economy a little bit here.
FlyQuest is going to have enough money to buy, but definitely it's going to bankrupt them. Reinvesting into this one, and it's a pretty big swing for Mind Freak. All picked up, couple of AKs as well. They're very happy with how that round went, and it's courtesy of Ricky. Totem pole boost puts him in a great position on the corner of Sandbags to find the first pick, and then also punishing another player up on half wall. Their util coverage wasn't quite good enough for FlyQuest. The Molly flushes him out of Sandbags, but there's no real like follow-up flash or anything like that, and he's able to get himself a bit of a freebie. So Mind Freak winning a round that they didn't really have much business winning. Going to help them out with their economy. Three players on the CT side with 3+K as a result. And yeah, as we can see here, 1900 loss bonus for FlyQuest, and they've had to empty the coffers just to be able to invest in this round. This is a huge opportunity for Mind Freak to get going on CT here after a pretty dry start to Inferno.
Apps control, the call to order for FlyQuest here. Looking like we are going to get a 5v3 pop on A. All in, no util really used over towards Banana. Retake util comes in, Mind Freak looking for that information, but they're not going to find it before the pop comes through. But they are ready for it. Lovely little crossfire from Texture and Gump to stop the pop out of Halls. And they're looking for more. In's 1v5, it's his turn at one. Bombs down up on the balcony. Molly. Oh, he goes through it. It was a very dangerous game and will be spotted by Tux over towards the arch swing. Third on the board, Mind Freak. Great round out of them. Starting to bolster the economy themselves. And just like that, I thought FlyQuest's economy might have lasted them another round. But after all those repurchases, those little rebuys they had to go back into, we got that swing happening.
Big turnaround for Mind Freak now. What, like 2.5 plus on all of these players? This CT economy is starting to get out of control. Dexter with an opportunity to open things up with the Deagle down middle. FlyQuest back to the drawing board just with the pistols this round. And Mind Freak, like, honestly, what we're seeing from them right now on Inferno, it really feels like it's the benefit of having to play a lot of these teams on Inferno, especially like Art of War. It's just a map they've been playing in the second map of every series lately, and I think that's why they're feeling so comfortable on it, pretty well on it. You know, they've just been having to play this every series. Really, really helps, especially when Art of War has got such a good strike rate on it. So, look, good position now. Once again, we said it also on Nuke that Mind Freak have had some pretty strong positions and some good turnarounds resetting the T-side economy, which you don't have many opportunities to do normally. And once again, they've been able to benefit from having a pretty big economy swing off the back of a half buy. This is where they need to try to convert and get as many rounds on this CT side as they can before they switch over to T.
Huge Ned lands right at the feet of Ali. Good double nade. Looks for extra damage. Inns gets bowled down, but still keeps on going forward, picking up the pace. FlyQuest happy with map control. Mind Freak not fully aware of how much damage they've done with these HEs this round. But Tux is ready.
It's another one from Tux as well. Like Tux and Ricky at that time double nading, but like Tux's nade timings, his util damage must be insane. Techstar having another one Inferno here actually. 100 ADR from him. He had a pop-off game on Inferno yesterday against Ardebor on the CT side, no less, so see if he's going to keep stepping up, peeking off the back of the pop flashes in towards dig side. Doesn't spot anything out. 5 grenades to get through the rest of the round here for Mind Freak, so, for FlyQuest rather, so it's going to be a pretty bare-bones execute on this A site. Jungle Wrap util comes out. 2 more flashes to be able to try to get on in here. See how they go.
Oh, a little stutter step. Won't be enough to bait that shot out. And Pain is hitting almost everything. In's going to be shooting that bullet straight back. Another 3v4. It's looking a little bit worse wear for FlyQuest. They're just trying to figure out where these extra members are. They don't quite spot or expect Text to still here in pit. Trap that they need to activate. Big play out of Texter. Nice little bait. Nice little shots. And that's going to be the lead found from Mind Freak, 5-4.
Yeah, completely turning this game around. Plant going to keep FlyQuest in the balance. You know, a couple of players sitting on 3.5, 3.8 may just go for like a Khalil buy here. Buy up into the next, but Mind Freak starting to get rolling now. Playing pretty well across the board. Good couple of shots from Pain. Looks like FlyQuest airing on the side of a half buy rather than going down to Khalil's here. Oh my god. Look at that util damage. Ricky going down. And Tux almost dead off the bat. Flash up over the top. They're trying to hit this B site with a lot of pace. Texter and Tux are both so low here, Mac.
Yeah, going a little bit of pace. Not investing the smoke on the Molly straight away. It is going to be CT dropping it. Molly's flashes going bloody everywhere. And it's Tux to try and keep it together. Pain's Molly gets the job done. The 5-7 coming through is not going to do enough. Could have brought it to that 2v2, but now it's all up to Gump in the 1v3. Retaking in from Banana. Vexite has that AWP in hand. And that smoke only has so much time left on it.
Don't mind this though. He's made it across onto the cheeky off angle. He probably wouldn't be expecting, but revealing his position, trying to take a few pot shots at Liaz. And Vexite's going to clean him up. FlyQuest winning with the Tech-9 armor. Off the back of basically util. Ricky goes down to Molly HE combo. Tux goes down to 20 HP and then an insta dink onto Texter. Just weakens that B side hold. They started with 3 players towards B and FlyQuest folded that pretty easily. Now Mind Freak, without much loss bonus behind them after losing against the half buy, might have a bit of a weird buy in round 12 if they drop this one. Could be a bit of a missed opportunity where, you know, realistically they could have been looking at an 8-4. It's going to be a lot closer of a scoreline now. Oh, I love that fake Molly towards the end of apps. Thrown out of the map so that Pain on the line, maybe catching that Dick Carp's defaulter. That was very cheeky from Mind Freak.
Playing a very dangerous game here, but Liaz decides it was too dangerous for him. Pain with the freezer push. Not going to connect. That looks good, but unfortunately, online CS sometimes do be like that. Tux going to be looking to lock down. Arch push here, flash in, Ali posted, and that nade is just going to do so much damage. Draw attention away. Liaz flicking around, finding both Gump and Tux. And Pain is going to go for the smoke push here. Full round the world to B is what we're going to see here, and Ricky's already low, so he's going to have to hit some crazy shots to make this one happen. All eyes on CT. Is that first man positioning not going to be good enough to stop that trade? Liaz comes through with the goods. And now Pain is probably just looking to save.
Yeah. FlyQuest tech armor by followed up by gun round win puts that pressure on the CT economy. And from what could have been an 8-4 for Mind Freak after their rough start turned around by their own heart by win, now it really feels like FlyQuest could be lining themselves up for a 7-5 in the very back and forth affair in this half. But I'm a little worried for Mind Freak. The last couple of games I've watched of their Inferno, all of the issues have come on their T side. Their CT's normally been pretty solid. Their T side has at times looked pretty lackluster. So that's why I was saying I wanted to see them get as much as they could out of this CT side, and I don't think they've quite done that.
Last of the half, are we going to go 6-6 again? And will Mind Freak be able to make it work with the full mixed bag again? Gump and Ricky going for the MP9s, M4s for Tux and Texter, and Payne, of course, with the AWP carried across, is going to give his red hot crack the best crack that he can. FlyQuest this time. Default utility over towards Banana. Bomb starting to make its way up mid. Expecting maybe some extra kind of aggression to come through with that deeper mid smoke.
Ollie, it's going to push Mind Freak back. Wanted to go again for that stack up on top of Sandbags to give Pain an off angle where he might be able to find a pick. Molly's exchanged again on Banana. Mind Freak, a dive. Half wall behind that. Not really much to find in Banana. In's kind of ready, playing from Olaf with the reactive flash. Bit of bracket control here for FlyQuest, and progression smoke over on jungle side will apply some pressure to Mind Freak. They can't just keep sitting 3B this entire round. And Pain gonna start to push forward and try to clear out Banana. In's creeping out from behind. The barrels goes one for one. The bomb's still at T stairs, and actually that smoke from the CTs is gonna allow Alistair to get it.
Wrapping around the long. Let's see if this can make it work, but Texter, incendiary to try and buy a little bit of space. Liaz looking to go over the top here. Texter very much ready for the swing. Will hold it down. Gump going to be able to find one from above. And just like that, things get even more difficult for FlyQuest to lock in a seventh. Dexite ready for the swing here at Library. Deals with the first man that they need to. And the last two CT's positions are known. Smoke making things a little bit awkward here. Ali. Posted, will hit that first shot, 11 points of health. But with the AWP in play, it might not matter. Slow peek straight into the crosshair of Exite. FlyQuest make it into the half with 7. They'll lead by 2. And in that second half, it's going to be a little interesting as to what they need to do to lock things out in.
Yeah, I think so too. I think Mind Freak, look, it's going to have to be a better T side than I've seen in the last couple of games from them. They had their opportunities here, especially turning around the game after the deficit that they started off with, losing round 2. But we'll see what they have prepared on the T side right after this short break.
Let's see where we end up. At the end of this half, is it going to be that 2-0, or are we going all the way to Anubis to separate these two teams? Let's find out together, hey? Second pistol would go a long way if Mindfreak can win this one, or at least get that plant down. So good amount of info, and Inz is feeling himself, running around like a madman.
Not a control taken by Mindfreak. A bit of a cross up top oranges with the dualies there for Vexite. It's got to be the main man you're scared of. Dex has got a fair bit of reactive utility as well. Peek out onto Dig. Doesn't net a kill for either side. Mindfreak organizing themselves for this AXE. Peek into Apps. Punished by Ricky. Great crosshair placement. Now only two players on the site here. Alistair bringing a kit to the party. Liaz is trying to hold on from pit side. There's the smoke to Moto, but Mindfreak actually going to wrap through jungle and split together. No, they go back to Dig. Molly flushing Liaz out. Alistair's already been gooshed. This pistol's looking great from Mindfreak.
Oh, look good. I thought they were going to find a second there, but just won't quite hit it. Ali. Bomb has been planted. Feeling it with that USP for the first shot, but not given the opportunity for any more than that. Progression smoke onto the site. Vexite going to be jumping up, but he won't see that man right by his side, and it is another pistol in the bag for Mindfreak.
Yeah, nicely done. I wanted to set that T-side pistol because it's going to give them a little bit more legs getting a good start like that in this T-half. See what they've been cooking. Force Buy is going to come out in round two here for FlyQuest, so got to make it through the pistol and armor before Mindfreak can keep chugging along. They've gone for 3 MAC-10s here as well, so maybe not anticipating the Force Buy. Could be definitely problematic against the pistol armor buy here. A lot of sets of head armor as well. It's only Ali who doesn't have any because he's saving for an ult. It's like Mindfreak going to use his hands by throwing a little cups pop out of Mac.
I like that angle for the HE in the pit, but Liaz ain't there this time. 5-7 up in your face, and Mindfreak respecting the block. Not going to be going for the full pop, looking to just walk up short instead. Where's that smoke going? All the way to library. Great timing on the reactive utility from FlyQuest. And Ali's in a nasty spot. Little one-way across the top, going to be able to find one. Beautifully positioned and dodges all that damage getting fired his way. Just like that, FlyQuest keeping Mindfreak guessing.
Yeah, I think Mindfreak just telegraphing things a little bit too much with the util into pit. Like you said, reactive util being returned from FlyQuest, making their life difficult. Smoke onto jungle side. There's the molly into pit. They still want to try to kick off this AX queue, but there's a hard crossfire across the site. Hit player has been able to make it off of Ballot. Liaz still alive here, starting to run out of bullets, but one of the last shots in the 5-7 connecting on one of these Mindfreak players' heads. Ricky's double-dinked Liaz. He's running around bloody everywhere, but picking up bomb, cops a face full of that flash. Spotted out by Liaz, getting wrapped on by Dexite. There's no way you can put this one together. Has been able to clear out the pit player, but 5 seconds, he's got to dink. Should be over. Well.
Hectic little round coming through there. Mindfreak unable to put it together, but you know, you need to complement FlyQuest's positioning in that one.
Yeah.
Able just to react off each other, able to activate, hit the shots they need to, and that is going to be two pistols now that Mindfreak have not been able to convert.
And that's what, like, you want to see. That's got the dink for no reason. Alistair spams Ricky back through the smoke, so not a big deal. I mean, like, FlyQuest just kind of doing it you would expect from the team second round of third, right? Like, it's the llama, the smokes, and HE. They're just going up inconvenient smoke about what Mindfreak is doing. Like, they were going for the top. If Neil should up and how much sound they will. If they're going to do that, they need contingencies for this reactive util. That's where, like, I really feel like you need the HEs to break smokes or something like that, or you need like a plan B if you get shot out of carps there. Like, I did feel like they had that a little bit. Like, we saw that jungle smoke get thrown out and they tried to wrap over on jungle side, but it didn't work out as cleanly as you would have liked. And this round, looking pretty clean. Got one bracket side, a fair few dings from the Glocks, but it's still four alive at the end of the day for FlyQuest. And up 9-6, you'd put your house on them closing out this game of Inferno. And I'm sure someone in the chat probably has, to be fair.
Chat, any takers, huh? Well, let's see where FlyQuest end up at the end of this one. Mind Freak on the guns themselves, after a quick one. And Dexter playing an incredibly dangerous game. Vexite drawing the attention away from him. And that smoke's going to fade at some point. Dexter getting ready to activate. Target selection going to be crucial here, but oh, Vexite, he is still there. Dexter might not actually get a chance to play the bloody game. Yeah, won't be able to find that shot, but the trades are there. He was put on the hook, and he caught the damn bait. Oh, Ricky, 1v4 angle. Okay, to do it, but Ali says no, and that was just continuous banana pressure to put a 10th on the board for FlyQuest.
Yeah. They're just starting to warm up on the CT side. And like I said, Mind Freak looking a little rusty, looking like putting the timings together on their own T side. I've already seen some issues against lesser opposition. So the same ones are rearing their head against FlyQuest. You don't really have much hope. Hell of a game from Vexi right now. 20 bombing in 16 rounds. Popeyes here. Get some damage on with the pistol armor, maybe.
Whoa. Dexter. Getting incredibly aggressive on that one. Ali, nice timing on the shots to find Tux through the smoke. And Mindfreak, we're just looking for that M4, but I believe it's been blown somewhere. Probably back towards Banana. Oh, there we go. Techstar finds it at the bottom of mid. And that's an upgrade to the firepower for Mind Freak this round. Hard crossfire. There's the activation. And that is incredible amounts of damage just pummeled onto Mind Freak. Swinging towards the bottom of mid. Ali snatches that away. And FlyQuest are doing everything right to win this one 2-0. But they still need two more rounds here.
Keen. Attack timeout. Mind Freak starting to run out of time in this game. Minus is very good to be closing on. See. That's what Mind Freak have come up with here. Haven't had much of a chance to play like a proper gun round just yet. The losing round two is that, yeah, find yourself falling behind pretty heavily.
How'd everyone sleep, by the way? I know 90% of people here are Australian, but I'm sure some of you degenerates woke up at 7 p.m. Don't tell me that you haven't. Nice little chip damage on a Techstar. Great opening from Ali and FlyQuest. Yeah, they are vibing right now. They are feeling it. Feeling it, Mitch.
For sure.
And again,
yeah, just extending that advantage. You take attack timeout as Mind Freak, you lose the first pick 5 seconds into the round on set. Kind of control, just going from bad to worse. Unfortunately, getting pushed around by Flax to have pushed all the way down bottom. Nana, these next up, Pain well aware that he's getting surrounded on.
Ooh,
not much he can do about it.
Ali opening the round and closing it. And look, that's why he's our Qadir player to watch. He is popping off this game. 20-9 for him, 22-9 for Vexite. It's crazy. It was great to see as well. Needs to be complimented, needs to be stated that Vexite, every time he's gone international, he hasn't really had those pop-off games that we're used to seeing from him domestically. But in Atlanta, he was having some really, really solid performances out of himself individually as well. It just felt like, yeah, whatever that analyst is doing for them, like, that might have been the difference. Just let them know, hey guys, these are your mistakes that you're doing. Please stop doing those mistakes. And has just optimized their gameplay, because we're getting another level of FlyQuest. Yes, on Nuke, it was a lot closer, but Mindfreak are a damn good Nuke team. Unfortunately, you can't say the same thing about Inferno, and FlyQuest are going to solidify the grand final position and snatch away any hopes of three OST teams at Pro League Season 21. But that is going to be 13-6, 2-0. FlyQuest get the job done, and now we're going to have that lower bracket game between Mindfreak and... Is that other game done? How are we looking?
Probably not. This one was a pretty quick one. Surely